22nd Foundation Day celebration of the M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation. I'll give a brief intro to the Foundation Day celebration for the benefit of the dignitaries sitting on the dais. Every year, the birthday of our beloved chairman, Professor M.S. Swaminathan, is being celebrated as the Foundation Day. And today is the 86th birthday of our beloved chairman. And thank you. Each one of us present here wish you a very happy birthday, sir. Next, our Executive Director, Dr. Ajay Pereira, will be delivering the welcome address, and he will be also highlighting some of the significant achievements of the foundation. May I request our Executive Director?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Professor Swaminathan, the birthday boy, and Madam Jayanthi Natarajan, dignitaries on the dais, trustees of the foundation, my colleagues at the foundation, invited guests, farmers and fisher folk friends, and gentlemen. Well, my colleague Manjula has wished Professor Swaminathan the birthday on behalf of all of you sitting here. But this event is being webcasted to all our 21 centers where we have been working, and although on behalf of all those people who are watching this function far away from here, on their behalf, sir, I wish you a very happy returns of the day. Today, I think this is the first visit of Madam to the foundation after he has assumed the So, Madam, as your new responsibility, we also welcome you to this particular foundation. May I also mention here that just on 29th of this month, both the Ministry of Environment and Forest and MSSRF have signed an agreement for a program in Badaranyam. And she said that this was her first official signature for the memorandum. So we're grateful for your kind presence, Madam. Well, you have a jam-packed program today. We are having some programs with the International Conference on the Mangroves, as well as launching some helplines for the fisher programs. And with the support of the Indian Overseas Bank, we'll be launching this farm school program. In addition to that, of course, our own Foundation Day's function. I'm not going to take much time on that, but at the same time, I must say that I have a difficult task ahead of me. I have to give you a presentation of a glimpse of activities which MSSRF has done, and combining the work which has been done by roughly about 350 staff spread over 6 different states of India and 21 different field stations. I do not know how much justice I'm going to do for their work in presenting in 10 to 15 minutes time, which I have at my disposal. So, welcome all of you to this particular. We are grateful for your kind presence. So I'll just go ahead with my small presentation. Well, as my colleague Manjula mentioned, this is the 22nd annual day of the foundation, but we're releasing the 21st annual report of this particular day. And this is from the beginning, I think Dr. Swaminathan has made, we have followed a tradition of releasing the annual report on 7th of August every day, and we have been doing for last 21 years without fail. I think that is what we have been. So if you look at MSSRF, I think MSSRF vision is essential to harness science and technology for sustainable and equitable development. We follow the principle of pro-poor, pro-nature, pro-women and pro-sustainable livelihood orientation to technology development and dissemination. We have focus on strategic and anticipatory research, the participatory research, technology and skill empowerment, and also our work based on our field level experience, we also take it what are the implications of the policy it has. Our spread, as I mentioned to you, we work in 6 states with 21 different locations. We work in the coastal fragile regions of Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Orissa and Tamil Nadu, biodiversity hotspots in Kerala, Orissa and again Tamil Nadu, eco-sensitive regions such as Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, and more of the agriculturally distressed areas in Maharashtra and Puducherry. So as I mentioned, that we work in 6 states with 21 field locations. For our convenience purpose, we have classified our different program area into what you call the coastal systems research, biodiversity, biotechnology, ecotechnology, food security, information education and communication systems, with climate change and the gender issues becoming the cross-cutting theme. And now we are debating within ourselves for the food and nutrition security also should take it as a cross-cutting themes in our entire program area. Our research has, both as I mentioned, the focus of the foundation is linking science with the society. Our research has led to what you call identifying several genes from the mangrove species and prosopis for both salt and drought tolerance as well as nutritional enhancement. We use modern biotechnological tools to bioprospect or identify the compounds or organisms which can be of agricultural or therapeutical use. We have made much advances in partnership with some of the institutions identifying certain lead molecules for the cancer and tuberculosis. We have developed science-based technology for restoration of the mangroves. We are have developed models for seawater farming because seawater comprises about 97% of the water which is available in the world is seawater, and how to use seawater as productive use. We have a program on a climate change where we analyze the sectoral impact the climate change has on agriculture, bioenergy, water, livelihood security, as well as policy decisions. We had both national consultations and regional consultation, which has led to what you call a Chennai plan for action in tackling the climate changes. We have, in area of biodiversity, we have discovered 9 new species this year, introduced 4,750 seedlings of rare endangered threatened plants. We have located natural population of, or rediscovered the natural population of 23 species, conserved more than 500 species of the medicinal plants in both Wayanad and Koraput region of Orissa. We have developed more knowledge management system for the soil and water conservation, fisheries. We have documented several best practices under NAREGA as well as agro intervention and community services. We have now completed a database of socioeconomic conditions of more than 12,000 farmers in 4 different states. We have also used advanced technology, as I mentioned. We use also GIS and remote sensing technology for our own natural resource management issues. We have conducted large-scale varietal selection trials in partnership with the community for identifying superior varieties. We have facilitated about 15 applications for the farmers' variety registration, helping the farmers in technically what you call the DOS characterization of the issues. Our atlases for the rural food insecurity, both for rural and India, rural and urban India, has been used by many policymakers as well researchers as a tool for identifying what is the extent of food security or insecurity. We also analyze socioeconomic issues which affects the food and nutrition security. Coming to our interventions, we have developed and facilitated large number of grassroots institutions, producer companies, farmers clubs, and taken up village development programs. We're working with more than 1,500 self-help groups in capacity building, livelihood strengthening with financial inclusion, which has crossed somewhere around 11 crores of rupees. And our focus program in Vidarbha region that we're working with about 54 women farmer groups. It is basically a program devoted to the women farmers of, the moment we say farmers, it is generally we construe as that male farmers, but it's a specific program focusing on the women farmers. We have developed several field level intervention improving agriculture productivity through what you call crop diversification, input management, value addition, and market linkages. We have introduced an integrated WADI program with the support of NABARD, which is going to cover 1,000 marginal farmers in Kollihil regions of Tamil Nadu. We have promoted several kitchen gardens and household medicinal plant gardens in almost about 1,000 households, and strengthened about the management of the community managed gene grain bank system in about 21 villages in the Koraput regions of Orissa.